So the first one, creating a BIM execution plan. Why do we need a BIM execution plan? Well, we're going to borrow the project cartoon here and understand that sometimes people have different views. And this one is how the customer explained it, and then how the BIM consultant described it, how the project was actually documented, what was installed, and then what the customer really wanted was just a tire swing. And this helps us to understand the importance of having a BIM execution plan. We really need to have a common agreement between multiple different teams, different disciplines, so that we can follow the standards and processes to get to the right outcome. Are they optional or are they mandatory?
Are they? Some places they are optional, and we're seeing a lot more mandatory actually. So a lot of governments are now mandating BIM execution plans.
And workflows and standards and being able to really hone in on what should be done, how it should be done, and rather than everyone following different practices, mm-hmm. really important to have the same.
All with the purpose, of course, not just because they want to, but they want to make their projects more consistent.
Absolutely. But why are some BIM execution plans and planning workflows unsuccessful?
Good question. Well, a lot of the feedback that we get on a daily basis sometimes is that their current BIM execution plan process takes too long, and it takes too long to create and manage.
And we also hear that some of them that are created as a PDF and sent on an email, they don't get read, and they get thrown away, or they get discarded, or only seen when there's a challenge, when there's a problem.
Then there's the agreement issue. So here we have mandated BIM execution plans, and not everyone agrees to that. So how can we get that to be more collaborative?
And how do we make sure that it doesn't end up in that drawer and gathering dust? So let's talk about some tips how to have a successful BIM execution planning workflow. The first one is having a central location for all of your team to be invited. We see huge benefit of having an online environment and making sure that everyone has access to the live BIM execution plan.
We see a lot of success also when teams actually build their BIM execution plans together. So instead of it being coming from one person, we see a lot of success and agreement when things aren't as mandated. It's more of a psychological thing.
Yep. We also see an increased engagement when you have good content in there.
Right.
So not having just a plain text document that's PDF'd and completely ignored. Why not add images and video, and actually video saving so many pages mm-hmm. of the document, and it's something that somebody actually wants to get interaction with.
Yeah, now one of the reasons why no one reads it is because it's so long, but saving a lot of pages with these videos for just training purposes has been so helpful for our customers.
Yep, and embedding also rich information like flowcharts and also iframes. Here we see a Matterport survey, so being able to have an as-built survey or a flow diagram embedded, mm-hmm. which is constantly updated for everyone has access to that BIM execution plan. Also, gaining multi-party agreement, trying to have all teams to agree on something is difficult, so you have commenting. And a lot of the time, teams will share a BIM execution plan as a PDF on an email. Some people will print it out and write their notes. Some people will send their notes in electronic form, but they will be all disparate. So keeping those together in the same agreement has been really beneficial for a lot of teams.
Yeah, it's a never-ending cycle when you're trying to agree on an entire document. That could be 50, 60, 120 pages long.
Ouch.
So splitting that up into bite-sized sections. So the commenting, approval workflow, sharing them and publishing them, and being able to comment on each and every single section allows you to just take that into more bite-sized pieces.
And sharing and publishing in those pieces,
right,
and archiving along the way. So having a lot of different gates as you develop in a collaborative form, a document, and then going through an approval process has a lot more advantage in gaining that multi-party agreement that's sought after. So quickly recapping on number one, which was BIM execution planning and helping that to be successful as part of your BIM management workflow. We see huge success when it's online and collaborative. We really see much more buy-in when people's comments are as part of that documenting process and making sure that they are along the ride rather than being disparate and disconnected. And then having an approval process that is actually in bite-sized form, so being able to approve certain parts without approving everything necessarily, and archiving along the way so that we've got security in knowing what versions have been released.
Right. And being able to access it because it's always live.
Always live. So having an online access everywhere is really important.